Thank you for tuning into the Queen Esther Missionary Baptist Church broadcast, located in Muskegon Heights, Michigan, under the leadership of Pastor Samuel Greer, Jr. Let the Word of God lead and instruct you. And now, let us go in and worship with the Queen.
I certainly want to give honor to my friend and my brother, much beloved. I thank God for him, and I thank God for our flourishing friendship. Queen Esther, you are blessed to have such a pastor as Dr. Samuel Greer. His lovely wife, Sister Greer. Come on, give it up. To all of these preachers here tonight, I was just saying in the back, when I come to Muskegon, it feels like I'm coming home, because I thank God for the fellowships that we have established down throughout the years. Amen. I thank God for our own Reverend Gannon, who came with us from Chicago. And these two brothers, won't you stand over there? Brother Breon Hutchinson. As a matter of fact, I'm almost through. Amen. I'm closing right now. I thank God for the work that your pastor is doing, not only here in Muskegon, but that he does now on a national venue. Your pastor is somebody. And I thank God for his friendship the Lord has established between my brother and I. Exodus chapter 12. Exodus chapter 12, and I just want to look at two verses tonight. Give me about 20 minutes, I'll be out your way. Amen. Exodus 12 and verse 12 and 13. Amen. When you get it, say amen. Reading from King James Version, you'll find the Word of God reads on this wise. Verse 12 says, "For I will pass through the land of Egypt this night, and will smite all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, both man and beast. And against all the gods of Egypt, I will execute judgment. I am the Lord. And the blood shall be to you for a token upon the houses where ye are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over, and the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you when I smite the land of Egypt." Amen. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, but the word of our God shall stand. If you don't mind, help me announce this lesson for tonight. Shake your neighbor by the hand one more time and say, "Neighbor, God's protection plan." Point at somebody and say, we are covered by the blood. You may be seated in the presence of God. This Exodus story is a very interesting lesson, for it shows God at his best, protecting his people. Yeah. It's a familiar story, a simple Sunday school lesson, fixed facsimile of how God hears the cries of his people that are in bondage. Pharaoh has kept them in bondage. He has kept them under hardship, but their cries have come up before the Lord. Thank God tonight that we serve a God that hears our cries. And when the cries come up before the Lord, he moves into action. And he calls Moses and says, "Moses, go down to Egypt and tell Pharaoh to let my people go." And he says, "When you go, tell them that I am that I am. And you know the story, don't make me tell the whole thing. You remember that Pharaoh's heart became hard. And he would not let God's people go. So God says, if you want a showdown, then a showdown is what you'll get. After a series of about 10 plagues, after God sends locusts, flies, frogs, turns the Nile into blood, and then lets darkness cover Lamb. By the time he gets to that last plague of darkness, he says unto Moses, it's clear that Pharaoh's heart is so hard that he's not going to let my people go. He says, but I want you to do this, Moses. He says, go down to Pharaoh and tell him that I say that at midnight I'm going to come through the land of Egypt and I'm going to smite the firstborn of every home, every handmaid, and every beast. But as for the people of God, there'll be no death. As a matter of fact, there won't even be a dog barking. It's in the Bible. You read it. There won't be no problems at all. It'll be all will be well in the homes of God's children. Chapter 12. Changes the calendar of Israel right there. And he gives them new instruction. He says, I want every home on the 10th day to be led by the male of that home to go and get a 1-year-old lamb without a spot or a blemish. He says, you take that lamb into your home, and on the 14th day, this is what I want you to do. I want you to kill that lamb. I want you to roast it. I don't want anything to be left. I want you to be standing there ready with your clothes on, with a stick in your hand. And after you slaughter that lamb, what I want you to do is I want you to take the blood from the lamb, and I want you to apply it to the doorpost and the that you are covered
explaining you what covered by the blood means, then I'll sit down and shout my own self happy. The first thing I want to tell you is that the blood covers us, first of all, because we've been purchased. Come on and help me preach this. We've been purchased with the blood of Jesus Christ. And listen, I don't know how you feel about it, but I thank God tonight that I am redeemed. I've been purchased with a cause. I have a song that even the angels cannot sing because I've been purchased. With the blood.
Yeah.
She was on her way to the World Trade Center with two of her co-workers. They had a meeting up on the 130-something floor. And she got into the cab and her nose started bleeding. And she says, I can't go in like this. You all go in. Told her two girlfriends go in. And they went up to the meeting on 130-something floor. She told the cab driver, take me back to the hotel.
Yeah.
She went back to the hotel and she went back up in her room. And she turned on the television. And while she was changing her blouse, those planes entered into the World Trade Center. Yeah.
Let me invite you now to ask the Spirit of God to create within you a spirit of purity. Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove that which is good and perfect will of God. I hope that you are moved to join me in worship here at the Queen Esther Church. We bless the Lord that we are here every Sunday morning at 8 a.m., at 11:15, at 2220 Superior Street in the city of Muskegon Heights. Remember, I'll be praying for you. Give me a call, 231-739-8825. Tell me what you want me to pray for you about, and I'll be happy to. May God be with you now. That's my prayer. See you next week.